Hey guys, welcome along. I know, just watching the Facebook feed, that a few of you are questioning what was happening. We just give you a bit of a countdown so you know something is happening. My name is Mark Howard, or Howie, and some big news coming out of the Caribbean Premier League, which we'll get to in a moment. But over the next half an hour, we'll have a special guest, Simon Helmet. You might have seen him on here a couple of weeks ago previewing the Pakistan Super League. Today, we are having a look at the Bangladesh Premier League, which kicks off in a very short period of time in Bangladesh. Wonderful competition, seven teams involved. We're going to have a look through the competition. Simon has coached all around the world. He's going to give you an idea of which players he think will be thinks will be effective over in that competition. And we'll, as always, pay a special focus to those involved in the Caribbean Premier League, those players involved in both competitions. So a lot to look forward to. But yesterday in London, a wonderful announcement for the Caribbean Premier League. The St. Lucia Zooks, who didn't have an owner, the last team that didn't have an owner, well, they do now. A gentleman out of the United States of America and India who is a wonderful businessman and a wonderful addition to the Caribbean Premier League. His name is Jay Pandya, and congratulations to Jay and his team. They now own the St. Lucia Zooks, which is absolutely brilliant. He's very positive about the Zooks going forward. They had a big press conference yesterday with Damien O'Donoghue and all the guys that run the Caribbean Premier League. This is what Jay had to say.
We're very excited to be a part of the St. Lucia community, as well as be a part of overall St. Lucia. We want to thank the government and Honorable Prime Minister Sir Alan Chesternick, and we look forward to being a part of the St. Lucia Zooks and looking forward to being the next champions going forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Jay. And looks confident too, Mr. Pandya, which is fantastic. So welcome along to the Caribbean Premier League family, to Mr. Pandya and his entire group, family and organisation. Great to have him on board. Now, he talked about next year in the Caribbean Premier League winning the championship. There's a man that would certainly like to do that. That is the captain of the Zooks, Mr. Darren Sammy. And Darren was also at yesterday's press conference in London.
This is for the Zook fans out there, you Zookers. Exciting times coming ahead. You know, we are just been bought. Mr. Pandya looking to do great things, and your captain Darren Sammy say big things coming. Cricket being played louder, you know St. Lucia is the place to be. Looking out for season 2017, cricket played louder. Boom.
Boom indeed. How cool is Darren Sammy? He's got a lot of fans around the world. Daz is probably watching. I know he messaged me about the Pakistan Super League preview show we did, so g'day to Daz and all the Zooks out there watching, and well done to everyone involved in the Caribbean Premier League. Exciting times ahead. Right, as I said though, kicking off in a couple of days' time in Bangladesh is the Bangladesh Premier League. There's seven teams involved. I welcome to the stage this man. He has blown up Facebook. He's bigger than Kim Kardashian. Simon Helmet is with us, assistant coach of the Sunrisers that won the IPL, involved with the Hobart Hurricanes, but also the Trinbago Knight Riders, the senior coach who took them to a title a couple of years ago. How are you, Simon? I'll call him Disco because we like nicknames here in Australia. How are you, Disco?
Howie, very good. It's great to see another great T20 league embarking on again in a couple of weeks' time. And we're going to see plenty of CPL players involved again across the world.
My word, we are. Now, you got invited back because you did a very nice job last time. So
pressure's on, you reckon?
The pressure's on. I'm not sure you've got to be quite as good as you were last time. Let's get straight into it, though, mate. And the seven teams involved. We'll start with the Chittagong Vikings. Iqbal is their, well, he's their number one character, category player. Wonderful player. But we'll start with the West Indian players. Gale, Dwayne Smith, Shoaib Malik has also played in the Premier League, Grant Elliott as well. They've got a wonderful combination. But for mine, as we spoke about last time, when you've got Chris Gayle on board, you've got 70% of the job done for mine.
Well, maybe. And he was obviously so important for the Tulluwas to win their championship, obviously this season as CPL. With Dwayne Smith, I'm not sure, quite sure they've ever combined together. Maybe for the West Indies, but not sure if they've combined in a T20 side before. So that'll be unbelievable. Shoaib Malik being one of the best players in the CPL. That's the beautiful part of this game now, playing all these competitions around the world. We can get these different combinations, and seeing those three at the top, they're going to be a tough lineup.
And that's the wonderful thing about it, Simon. I think in the past, probably in the last 10 years, a bit of animosity and competition between, say, for example, the Australian and Indian sides. All of a sudden, Ricky Ponting's in the same dressing room as Harbhajan Singh, and they're all of a sudden best friends.
Absolutely. All the those problems they may have had when they played against each other, country versus country, quite different now. These guys play so many places, so many competitions, all around the world. And look, that first team in the Bangladesh Premier League, they're going to be a very, very good side.
They've got Abdul Razak as well. He's a very, very effective player. I like Grant Elliott. We haven't seen him a great deal of him. Did some wonderful things out here in the World Cup. Was at the Caribbean Premier League. When he gets going, that man can go. Good-looking man, too. He's sort of a bit of a male model out
certainly
here.
Rates himself as well.
He does.
The looks department.
He does.
We know that. But he'll be happy with the new ownership, and he'll be hoping that he'll be playing with the Zooks next year. He was obviously part of that side. Yep. Made the finals for the first time last year, the Zooks, so I can see the new ownership and Darren Sammy are very, very keen to make sure that they improve upon that. Tullawas have won two championships. Barbados have won one championship, and obviously the Trinbago Norris have won as well. So the Zooks and, of course, St Kitts, they're the ones who are still looking out for that elusive championship.
My word. Now, before we get into the rest of the teams, you've been involved in recent times in Bangladesh cricket, so you've spent some time in the beautiful country that is Bangladesh. And hello to everyone watching on the subcontinent and in Bangladesh. And before we go any further, send us any comments via Facebook if you want to ask any questions to Disco or even myself. I don't know why you'd want to do that, but if you did. And at the end of this session, we will try and answer some of the questions out there. I know there's a big subcontinental audience watching at this stage, so send it through on comments at Facebook and we'll try and answer them. Bangladesh as a cricketing venue and T20, what type of pitches do we expect to see and what type of players do we need to be effective in these conditions?
Spin, spin, spin. Obviously very effective in the subcontinent. And we saw in this last test match where Bangladesh played, it was fabulous, playing England, went down the wire, 22-run finish. That was really tight. Stokes getting the job done at the end. We saw how important spin is, how important it is to bat some time. But once you get in those conditions, you can certainly bat big. It might take some time to get in, but certainly once you get that opportunity, you've got to make sure you make it worth your while. I think the Bangladesh cricket team, with Coach Hatrasinghe, are absolutely moving forward again. I reckon there was a lull for a while there, but we're seeing some really good players. We've seen Shakib Al-Hassan, who's played everywhere in these T20 competitions, was part again of the successful Tullawas team last season. Had a bit of a go at the Renegades here in Melbourne. I think he might have been in Adelaide at some stage too.
He was, yes.
In T20 cricket. And there's a fella who I don't think's in that side due to a shoulder injury. He was a successful member of the Hyderabad Sunrise, Mustafa Rahman, or we call him the Fizz.
The Fizz?
A lot easier to say in
the
team.
The Fizz?
Spoke very little English in a place where, you know, English was the in a team meeting. That was the, you know, Dave Warner and Tom Moody, the coach, would often talk in that language. And he couldn't speak as much of that, but tell you what, did he speak with his bowling?
Oh,
unbelievable Yorkers. Got Andre Russell, one of the most unbelievable in-swinging Yorkers, which took out his middle and leg stump. Hope he gets a speedy recovery, because he's also a really effective player in Bangladesh cricket, but also in what it's going to be in the Bangladesh Premier League.
As I said, seven teams, and great to have Simon here to just pull these sides apart. You mentioned Shakib Al-Hassan.
He's a beauty.
Best soft shell crab. He's got the restaurant.
Have
in
you been
Dhaka.
There? Have you been to that restaurant?
I haven't been there yet, but they tell me if you go to Bangladesh, that is the one restaurant you go to. Go and ask for Shakib, say Howie and Simon sent you, give you half price on the shop.
Apparently.
Well, maybe. Maybe. All right. The second team, the Victorians. Mortaza's right up the top there. We have a look at Sahil Tanveer and Imad Wasim, two gentlemen that had really effective times with the ball. Imad Wasim, no one could get him off the square. Very, very, very hard to score off. And Tanveer, we spoke about it a couple of weeks ago, that unusual action. But let's focus on Imad Wasim at the moment. What makes him so difficult to get away in a spinning paradise like Bangladesh? He's going to be a real player to look out for.
It's the art of deception. And his subtle changes of pace. He can spin the ball, but often the wicket-taking delivery is the one that goes straight on. They'll hit the pad, they'll hit the stumps. And that's why a lot of the subcontinental players are so clever. And for the Australians, for the English and South Africans, at times they find that very, very difficult. It isn't a brilliant to have so much of the subcontinental flavour with the Caribbean players, who are used to spin in the Caribbean conditions as well, with all the other players who have come from Australia, like I say, England and South Africa. This is going to be a fantastic competition, and it tests everybody's skills. With Tanveer and the Fizz, not only are they effective fast bowlers, you like the Fizz, don't you?
I'm just trying to hope our audience is getting across your terminology about
I'm
the Fizz.
I'm sure they will.
They will.
Nicknames earlier, didn't we?
We?
Is the change of the pace. And that's why Tanveer has been so effective all around the world on good bouncy wickets, and also on spinning wickets in the subcontinent.
My word. Some other gentlemen I've highlighted here for the Victorians. Kulasekera is an unbelievable young player that's done the job time and time again. Jason Holder as well, who's done some wonderful work in charge of the West Indies. Great to see him getting himself involved in T20 cricket. He bats, he bowls. hard man to get out, and a heart the size of a lion for mine, Jason Holder.
He's terrific. Been thrust into captaincy very early in his career, and obviously that's, you know, proven some difficulties for him and his form. However, he can hit a ball as far as anyone in the Caribbean, and he's very, very good with his deceptive bounce. He's often a bowler who'll bowl three overs in the power play, and maybe bowl straight through in the first 10 overs because he gets that extra bounce. Good to get wickets.
Yeah, and he got a lot of fans out here in Australia when they were last out here.
Nice
guy. He was a difficult team to lead. They were having their problems, but he was fantastic.
They were getting wiped, Howie.
Well, yeah.
And he had a brave face every time in every press conference. And look, I think he's only going to grow as a leader and also as a player.
Yeah, they were getting smoked. All right, the third team involved in the Bangladesh Premier League that we'll look at is the Dhaka Dynamites. Really nice team. And they are at the top, Shakib Al-Hassan, as I said, soft shell crab, 50%. Just go and tell them that Howie and Simon sent you. Some wonderful players in here, but I have a look at these four. Kumar Sangakkara, Talawaz. Andre Russell, Talawaz. Mahela Jayawardene, one of the best cricketers ever to play the game. Dwayne Bravo, you also throw in Evan Lewis, the young man, and Ravi Bapara. Wow, that's a team and a half, isn't it?
Yeah, the winners there, Howie.
Yeah, I know,
you last of my tip. That's going to be my tip right now. To have Andre Russell and Dwayne Bravo, two of the best all around the world. Jayawardene and Sangakkara playing in the same team. Are they in the same team for the PSL? Did we mention that last?
They do,
absolutely.
They say, well, I'll play, but as long as he's playing.
Shakib, we're coming as a package.
That's right. That's exactly right.
So those two together with their experience, oh, wow, they're going to be a good team. Evan Lewis, he's just broken into the West Indies side. He's a really talented cricketer also. I think for me, and with that international influence, they're the team to beat.
Yeah, they're a wonderful, wonderful lineup. Check out on the Facebook page of CPL a series called Hanging with Howie, which is me. It's going to win awards, this caper.
Just while you're getting the free dinner with Shakib.
Yeah, exactly. But it's a series of behind the scenes look at some of the cricketers and what they get up to away from cricket. The first one was Dwayne Bravo this week about jewellery. And you'll see several with Dwayne and Shane Watson and Andre Russell. They'll come out every Wednesday at this stage. Just little tidbits just to keep you interested.
Nice.
So keep an eye for those. Hang with Howie on the CPL Facebook page. All right, the Titans. Now, this is a really interesting team. Nicholas Puran is involved there. Ricky Wessels, Kevin Cooper. They've got a really nicely balanced side. Now, have a look at a couple of the bowling options. One from Australia here, Benny Lachlan, and Lendl Simmons, who gets the job done here in this part of the world in the big bash for the Heat. They're a really nicely balanced side. Ricky Wessels, as I mentioned, Benny Lachlan, Lendl Simmons. Lendl Simmons, a good player out of the Caribbean.
Yeah, he's an excellent player. Hasn't had as much success outside of the Caribbean Premier League, except for actually IPL, where he's actually made 100 for the Mumbai Indians.
Ricky Ponting loves him because he says every time I call him to the crease to do something, he makes runs.
He goes and gets the job done, which is the sort of guys that you love as a coach, and now Ricky is. Two of the most exciting players in the world, Howie.
Mm.
Nicholas Puran.
Yes.
Can hit the ball out of sight, probably 5'9", 5'10". Needs to do some work with Dinesh Ramdin with his keeping, but I'm sure the two Trinidadian boys will get together and he can improve that. But him as a clean hitter, unbelievable, as is Ricky Wessels.
Yeah.
Two really exciting players in that particular side. With Lendl Simmons' experience, and who was he? Kevin Cooper?
Kevin Cooper.
Trinidadian boy.
Absolutely.
Tobago Knight Rider. He's also very effective on the wickets, as he is with the CPL. So they're actually quite a neat side. I reckon they'll finish in the top few.
I shouldn't have omitted Fletcher as well. Andre Fletcher.
Yeah.
He was doing the job at the top of the order in the last CPL. Good player.
Yeah, a good Zooks player, being involved with the winning World Cup for the West Indies in India this year. So I think they have some real experience. And again, as we spoke about with the Pakistan Super League, we're seeing a very, very good spread of Caribbean players playing all around the world in all these competitions.
Everybody wants them because they are the entertainers, and the Caribbean Premier League for mine has some of the best players in the world. Everyone likes to go over there and play cricket, so it's great to see these, especially the young West Indians starting to play around the world as well. As I said, send us messages on comments on Facebook as we speak at the moment. Send us any questions you like, and myself and Simon might be able to help you out with a few answers. We move on to the Kings. And they've got the Kings.
There's always a Kings in every T20 competition.
There
maybe
is.
Except for Big Bash. Every competition otherwise.
We'll work on that. And the King is at the Kings, Darren Sammy. We heard him earlier on. I just can't say enough about this fella. As far as a cricketer goes, I'm disappointed he's not out here in the Big Bash. But as a captain, Simon, he's a leader of men.
He's a terrific guy. I've had the good fortune to work with Darren in a couple of places. And rivals in CPL. But to work with him the Hurricanes last season, to work with him the Hyderabad Sunrisers in the IPL, he is a person, not glass half full, his glass is overflowing.
It's overflowing.
He's such a positive person around the group. And You would not know whether Darren's made a first baller, or he's been hit round the park, or he's made 100. He stays very level. Always laughs at your jokes, which is always good. It makes you feel pretty good about yourself.
And not many people laugh at yours.
Not many. No. But also one of the guys, when he does laugh, he stands and does a twirl and sits down again. Your mate Smokey Viv Richards, he does the same thing, I think.
And Mr. Richards to you.
Sorry,
Smokey to me.
That's right.
So Darren Sammy will be a wonderful addition there. They've got some other wonderful young players and a couple of young Bangladeshi players to keep an eye out for. So that is the Kings. Then the Rangpur Riders, Shahid Afridi, Gidron Pope and a few others, but I tell you what, Shahid Afridi, we don't see enough of these players, especially in Australia. We haven't seen him in the Big Bash. Love to see Shahid Afridi because he bats, he bowls, he fields, he's a gun.
He's unbelievable. He's before his time. I think he was playing 2020 in Test matches 20 years ago.
He was.
An exceedingly good player, obviously been a leader for his country for many years. Came out in the very first year of the Big Bash, actually.
Early
he played for the Renegades, and look, he's a terrific player. He's a match winner. And he can win the match with the bat or with the ball, usually in the middle order these days, doesn't usually bat at the top. His spin, again, the art of deception for him, he bowls that fast, quicker ball that that goes onto the stumps, or that slower leggy. He's a versatile player. Any team that has Shahid in, it's a good chance. Pope's an interesting selection.
Yeah,
and again, they've obviously looked at their squad and decided, we need someone with express pace. Well, this kid's fast, proper fast. And I'm sure, you know, the West Indian selectors are looking at this guy, as well as obviously people involved with the CPL. So interesting to see guys like Puran, Evan Lewis, and also Pope are getting their chance in another T20 competition.
And that's the great benefit of the Caribbean Premier League, as we've been speaking about. One side to go, the Barisal Bulls, Rahman charge up the top there, and my man, Carlos Brathwaite. Remember the name, Carlos Brathwaite. I think I said that last time.
You did say it last
time. Well, I can't help but say it. He's had a really interesting career. He'll be forever known as the man that won them the T20 World Cup when he took down Ben Stokes. But he's a wonderful player. He's played some Test cricket. He's got a really interesting period of time ahead of him as far as career goes.
Yeah, he has. A man with huge hands. Not sure we've ever shaken his hand, Howard, but he is a big, strong man, a great fielder, just like Pollard and Bravo and those other really big fellas in the Caribbean. He's been playing with some kits. Didn't see him as much last year, unfortunately, in the CPL. Has now transferred his game as being a short version or T20 specialist now into Test match cricket.
Right, yeah.
So that just shows the class of the player. He's a real gentleman. He plays the game hard, but off the field he's a real gentle giant. He's going to be important for that side as an overseas all-rounder. He needs to be an influencer. He's sort of been behind Pollard and Bravo and Russell, where his time's going to shine. Whereas Pollard and Bravo and those fellas finish, in a few years' time, he's going to be a person that's going to be really important with Jason Holder to be part of the West Indian fabric, but also part of some very successful T20 competitions around the world.
I'm disappointed. I'm looking everywhere for my man, Rodman Powell, and I can't see his name on a
list.
He's
not there?
Well, I don't know what's happening with the draft over there. I don't know if Rodman was sick. I'm not sure. But
he may have forgotten to put his name on the list,
I don't usually
miss many.
I'm picking him for every side that plays cricket. As I said last time, he's a wonderful, wonderful player. So you think, though, the Dynamites with Sangakkara, Russell, Jai Warner and Bravo, as well as Lewis and Bapara, they look the team on paper, but as you know, it so often comes down to getting on a roll at the right time in the competition as well.
Well, it certainly does. Hopefully you can play well together and integrate well, and that's always the challenge for a coach and a team. You usually have a week and a half pre-season to get to know everybody's names, to know how the hierarchy works and where you're playing and where your locker is.
That's it. After that,
you've got to get out in the middle and perform together, and that's the art of T20 cricket as far as a team and a culture. But like I said, all the names that you've mentioned today, especially what nearly 15 to 20 names from the Caribbean, they're pretty experienced guys. They know how to go about being involved with successful teams. And look, let's face it, the West Indies have been the best team, the only team to win two World Cup T20s. And any team that boasts, Gale or Bravo, didn't see Coran Pollard in this particular competition. But all the others, Andre Russell, etc., any teams that got those fellas, they're going to be hard to beat. This will be an intriguing competition. I think something that we're going to find also, we're going to see some great Bangladeshi players, just as we have with the CPL, come through, and all of a sudden we're going to see more of those names across the world.
Which is absolutely fantastic. Now, we put out the offer to send some questions in. Now, we have got a production staff of one who has been compiling these questions as we speak. You'll see his hand enter. You might even see him. Welcome, come on. This is Michael James. He's in charge of this.
He's real.
MJ. He's a real person. Good on that's enough. Some good questions coming in. All right. Now, righto. Warris. G'day to Warris, if I've got the pronunciation of your name right. Great to have you on board. Now, he wants to know, How about the Rangpur Raiders, who we spoke about, who have got a wonderful team with Shahid Afridi on board. A really, really effective combination. Also, Khan plays in that side. Saka is right up the top. You can have a look at the full side there, Simon.
I will do. That was the final one there?
The second one there.
Yep.
There we go.
Yes, I'm with you.
The Rangpur Raiders. A big fan of Shahid Afridi. Let's be honest, there's some names that wouldn't be known to international cricket there. So they're going to need, for mine, some impressive performance by some of their lesser-known players.
We've had a fellow, Nazir Jamshed, play for Trimbago a couple of seasons ago from Pakistan. There's Senanyaka, the really effective off-spinner from Sri Lanka. So, again, as you said, Howie, you may not be the most prominent names, but if you can combine, work well, know your role, get it done, get the job done, then this team could work very well with a match winner like Afridi. So don't write them off.
Okay, so thank you very much to Waris for sending that one in. Now, R.S. Rakib, I think he's coming in from the subcontinent. He's loving Disco's work.
No further question to that one. Well done. Well played, well done.
What about the bloke hosting the show, mate? Anyway, now, Shamrat. G'day to Shamrat out there. Great to have you on board. Thinks the Chittagong Vikings will win the whole competition, Simon?
I think they're going to be an effective team with Chris Gayle, with Dwayne, the Dr. Smith, and also Shoaib Malik. They're going to be up there. I had them in the top four. I'm not backing them. I've got, who was it, the Dakar team, the Dakar Dynamites. I think they're going to be the winners. However, any side with Chris Gayle in it, look out.
Good on you, Shamrat. Thanks for giving us your thoughts. Nadeem, in from Saudi Arabia, says hello. So, hello to you, Nadeem. Great to have you on board. Hope things are going well in Saudi Arabia at the moment. Cricket is expanding, Simon.
It is
expanding, which is wonderful.
And again, another really interesting test match between Pakistan and the West Indies.
Yes.
And we saw the spin again. Just incredible spinning from the Pakistan side. I think 17 nearly out of the 20 wickets, I believe, went to spin. And aren't Pakistan amazing at the moment? They're really... I'm looking forward to them coming out to Australia and playing the Aussies.
A three test series out here shortly.
It's going to be very, very interesting to see what happens there.
They've got a really good bowling attack as well. And that is it for the questions. So great to have your questions coming in. Just before we go, I spent some time just for our subcontinental audience. Michael Clark has got a book out at the moment called My Story, and it's got received a lot of press in this part of the world. I sat down with Michael this morning for a little podcast called The Howie Games. You can get it on iTunes. Just check out The Howie Games. You can get it on iTunes, and Michael's episode will be up next Thursday. There's been a lot of negative press about it. I could not have found Michael more engaging, more warm, more giving, more friendly. It's been a really interesting reception to his book here in Australia. I'm sure it'll be launched overseas as well with some of the negative comments. But this is a man, Disco, that just loves cricket. Loves getting his first pair of Puma Sheffields. Loves getting his first full-size bet. Loves playing his very first game. Just a passionate man. And I think a real positive for Australian cricket, Michael Clark, and his time he charged.
Very good leader as far as tactics go. During a successful period of Australian cricket.
That's right.
Not easy to come in after the captain of Ricky Ponting. Look, let's face it, whether it's in politics, whether it's in sport, some leaders are loved, some people can easily be criticised. And for Michael, I think he's probably worn the both sides of it. Some people have really enjoyed his leadership, some people have challenged it in different ways. But we're very interested to watch your interview, mate.
You just listen in, a podcast on iTunes, and check out Michael Clark's book as well, My Story. It's a really good one. I think, Disco, we're about ready to wrap up.
Fantastic.
It's sort of 6 o'clock in on Friday afternoon here, so... We need to get Simon out of here because he's got things to do. Your young bloke's playing cricket at the moment.
I haven't got a message yet, so he's not out, I think. Going okay.
Well,
I think he was opening the batting tonight.
10 years' time, he might be in the Bangladesh Premier League. Hopefully he's a bit more technically correct than his dad.
He's up.
This one very early on. Hey, guys, we really appreciate you joining us. Next Wednesday we'll have another edition of Hanging with Howie with another superstar from the Caribbean Premier League. Whenever you see this countdown that did start behind us and you start saying, what's going on? You know that there's a couple of superstars about to appear on your screen, so make sure you check it out. Until next time, guys, thank you, Disco. Well done.
Good on you, Howie.
We'll see you guys soon from the Caribbean Premier League. Peace.